At Apple's music event in San Francisco on Wednesday, maybe the biggest news wasn't the revamp of iTunes or the availability of new iPods, but the return of Steve Jobs. Following his several-month absence from the company, he was greeted with a standing ovation.
As some of you may know, about 5 months ago, I had a liver transplant. So I now have the liver of a mid-20s person who died in a car crash and was generous enough to donate their organs. And I wouldn't be here without such generosity. So I hope all of us can be as generous and elect to become organ donors.
Another headline included the announcement of a video camera on the new iPod Nano.
Back of every Nano is a video camera and a microphone integrated right in. And there's a speaker inside as well to listen to the music, to listen to the sound of your videos. So built into every iPod Nano is now an awesome video camera.
The Nano can display video or sync it back to your computer where you can upload the clip to YouTube. Videos can be shot at 30 frames per second at 640 by 480 resolution. The microphone can also be used with the Nano's new voice recording feature. Other than the camera, the physical form factor of the Nano remains mostly unchanged, although it now features a larger 2.2-inch display and comes in new colors. The 8-gig model costs $149 and the 16-gig $179. Apple cut the price on its 8-gig iPod Touch while boosting the capacity of other models. The 8-gig Touch now costs $199, a $30 price cut. The company added a 64-gig model for $399. According to Phil Schiller, Apple Senior Vice President, the 64 and 32 gig touches are now 50% faster and feature support for OpenGL ES version 2.0, the cross-platform graphics API. With reporting by Stephen Lawson, Jason Snell, Dan Frakes, and Dan Morin, I'm Nick Barber, IDG News Service.